Welcome to Geotech Practical Problems. Index Properties in Soil Classification. Number 3, AASHTO Soil Classification System. Before we continue, please like and subscribe and click the bell icon to get new video updates on your weekly geotechnical topics. This classification system was originally proposed in 1928 by the U.S. Bureau of Public Roads for use by highway engineers. A committee of highway engineers for the Highway Research Board met in 1945 and made an extensive revision of the PRA system. This system is known as the AASHTO System or American Association of State Highway and Transportation Officials System, ASTM D3282, AASHTO Method M145. The AASHTO system is based on the following three soil properties: 1. Particle size distribution. Gravel, fraction passing the 75 mm sieve and retained on number 10, 2 mm, U.S. sieve. Sand, fraction passing the number 10, 2 mm, U.S. sieve and retained on the number 200, 0.075 mm, U.S. sieve. Silt and clay, fraction passing the number 200, U.S. sieve. 2. Plasticity. The term silty is applied when the fine fractions of the soil have a plasticity index of 10 or less. The term clayey is applied when the fine fractions have a plasticity index of 11 or more. 3. If cobbles and boulders, size larger than 75 mm, are encountered, they are excluded from the portion of the soil sample on which classification is made. However, the percentage of such material is recorded. The AASHTO system classifies soils into 7 major groups, A1 through A7. The first three groups, A1 through A3, are granular, coarse-grained soils, while the last four groups, A4 through A7, are silt clay, fine-grained soils. To classify a soil according to the AASHTO table, the test data are applied from left to right. By the process of elimination, the first group from the left into which the test data will fit is the correct classification. Silt and clay soils are located within the plasticity chart, as shown in this figure. Group index. The group index, GI, is a means of rating the value of a soil as a subgrade material within its own group. It is not used in order to place a soil in a particular group, that is done directly from the results of sieve analysis, the liquid limit and plasticity index. The group index number is written in parentheses after the group or subgroup designation. The higher the value of the group index, the poorer is the quality of the material, so the GI should not exceed 20 for any of groups A4 through A7. The group index is a function of the amount of material passing the number 200 sieve, the liquid limit and the plasticity index. The group index is given as this equation, where F is percent passing number 200 sieve and the other terms have been defined before. The GI index is reported to the nearest whole number, 2.4 reported as 2, 2.5 reported as 3, and if GI, 0, it is set to 0. GI for groups A1A, A1B, A24, A25, and A3 is 0. For groups A26 and A27, the partial group index, PGI, is used. Classification procedures. 1. Identify the percent passing the number 10, number 40, and number 200 sieves. Identify the LL and PI of the fraction passing the number 40 sieve. 2. Using the AASHTO classification table, move from left to right, using the process of elimination, until the first group consistent with the laboratory data is identified. 3. Calculate the group index or partial group index. If the equation yields a negative number, report it as 0. Always round the group index, GI, to the nearest whole number. For the A1A, A1B, A24, A25, and A3 soils, GI equals 0. For the A26 and A27 soils, GI equals partial GI. Example number 1. Classify the following soil by the AASHTO classification system. Passing number 10 sieve, 100%. Passing number 40 sieve, 92%. Passing number 200 sieve, 86%. Liquid limit, LL, 70. Plasticity index, PI, 32. solution. Percent passing the number 200 sieve is 86%. So, it is a silty clay material, i.e., A4, A5, A6, or A7, as shown in the table. Proceeding from left to right, we see that it falls under A7. For this case, PI equals 32 and LL equals 70. So, this is A7.5. From GI equation. Now, F equals 86, LL equals 70, PI equals 32, so GI equals 33.47 equals 33. Thus, the soil is A7.5.33. Example number 2. The following data refers to a silty clay that was assumed to be saturated in the undisturbed condition. On the basis of these data, classify the soil according to the AASHTO systems. Solution. Number of passing number 200 sieve equals 90%. Liquid limit equals 45%. Plasticity index equals 25%. With this, the soil is classified as either A7.5 or A7.6. Input LL and PI to plasticity chart, and the soil is clay, A7.6. Group index is 23.63, or say 24. So the soil classification is A7.6.24. Example number 3. Determine the AASHTO classification of soils A, B, and C in the table below. Solutions. Sample A. Start at the left, and compare sample results to the table criteria. The percent passing the 200 sieve, 18%, is less than 35%, cohesionless soil. Both LL and PI are zero, non-plastic soil. The first match will be soil type A1B. The GI for A1B soil is zero. Classification is A1B, zero. Sample B. The percent passing the 200 sieve, 25%, is less than 35%, cohesionless soil. LL equals 22, PI equals 11, larger than 6. This must be an A2 soil. Beginning with A2.4, compare the sample results with the table criteria to obtain A2.6. For groups A2.6 and A2.7, use partial GI, so PGI equals 0.10, reported as 0. Classification is A2.6, 0. Sample C. The percent passing the 200 sieve, 85%, is greater than 35%, cohesive soil. LL equals 61, PI equals 30. Begin with A4, and compare the requirements in the table to get A7.5 or A7.6. To determine whether the soil is A7.5 or A7.6, use plasticity chart. In this case, PI equals 30 is less than LL minus 30 equals 31, and the soil is A7.5. GI equals 29.25, reported as 29. Classification is A7.5.29. Example number 4. Particle size analyses were carried out on two soils, soil A and soil B, and the particle size distribution curves are shown in the figure. The Atterberg limits for the two soils are in this table. Classify soils A and B in according to the AASHTO system. Which soil is better for a subgrade? Solution. Determine percent passing number 10, number 40, and number 200 sieve. Make a table of values according to AASHTO table. Soil A, 88% passing number 200. Therefore soil A is silty clay. Based on the AASHTO table, soil A is A4. The group index is 5.43, reported as 5. So, the classification for soil A is A4.5. Soil B, 20% passing number 200, thus make soil B a granular. Based on the AASHTO table, soil B is A1B. Soil B is non-plastic. Therefore, GI equals 0. Hence, the classification for soil B is A1B, 0. Refer to AASHTO table to decide which soil is better for a subgrade material. According to AASHTO table, soil B, A1B, is an excellent material for a subgrade. Soil A is fair to poor. Soil B is then the preferable material. Example number 5. The results of a particle size analysis of a soil are given in the following table. No Atterberg limit tests were conducted. A. Would you have conducted Atterberg limit tests on this soil? Justify your answer. B. Classify the soil according to AASHTO. C. Is this soil a good foundation material? Justify your answer. Solution. A. Number of fine content in the sample is 4.1%. This means the majority of the soil particle is granular material or sand. Sand is non-plastic, and the amount of fine content is too few, so it will crumble once the plastic limit test conducted. So, Atterberg limit test is unnecessary. B. The percent passing the number 200 sieve is 4.1, so it is a granular material. The percent passing the number 10 sieve is 70.2, and the number 40 sieve is 49.8, so the category is A1B. The GI for A1B is 0, so the classification is A1B, 0. C. According to AASHTO table, A1B, 0, is excellent to good, and also generally the non-plastic material is not affected by swelling or shrinking, so this material is a good for foundation material. Thank you for watching Geotech Practical Problems number 3, AASHTO Soil Classification System. See you in the next video.